सदाशिव समारंभाम् शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम् ओम सर्वं You are listening to the Vedantic Kritis of Sadashivendra Saraswati or Sadashiva Brahmendra Saraswati. In his Kritis, I have selected some of the Kritis which are connected to Saguna Ishvara and which are connected to Nirgunam Brahma. After completing few Kritis of Saguna Ishvara Kritis, from last two Kritis I am giving you the Vedantic Kritis of that Brahmendra Saraswati. Vedantic Kritis means the Kritis contains that Vedantic teaching. Vedantic teaching is that Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya. Brahman alone is real. Jagat, the experiential world, is unreal, mithya. Jivo Brahmaiva Naparaha. The individual is Brahma Eva, Jivo Brahma Eva. Na Paraha. Jiva is none other than Brahman only. This is the content of Vedanta. Now in this Kriti, Sadashiva Brahmendra takes us to the culmination. Culmination means the final abode where one can attain moksha, that liberation. That teaching he gives in this Kriti. Sarvam Brahmamayam. He says, everything is Brahman. All is one Brahman only. Rere. Rere means, it is like a sambodhana, addressing. Addressing his own mind or addressing the seekers, the mumukshus, also we can take. If we want that meaning, he is addressing those seekers of moksha. Normally in Telugu, we say Ori, Osi, Oyi, Sambodhana, that like that here in Sanskritam, Re Re, Sarvam Brahmamayam, everything is Brahman only. Sarvam Brahmamayam. What is this Brahman? Brahma means, it is derived from the Sanskrit root brh dhatu. Brh means that which is big, to be big. That is big is called brh, brhattamatvat brahma. That which is big is called Brahman. This Brahman is sarvam, everything. Kalvidam brahma. Upanishad says, idam sarvam brahma khalu. This is everything is Brahman only. Is it not brahma mayam? Bigness means what here? Size wise big, or immediately we think it is big in size. What way it is big? Taittiriya Upanishad says, it is big in the sense, it is beyond space, beyond time, and beyond that object limitation. Deshe kala vastu aparichinnaha parichinna rahitaha. It is infinite, space wise, time wise, and object wise. So deshe kala, beyond time and space. Very difficult to understand, to grasp. Therefore, Upanishads tries to communicate to us easily. Isha Vasya Midam Jagat. In Isha Vasya Upanishad, Isha Vasya Midag Sarvam Yatkincha Jagat Yam Jagat. Whatever is there in this world is nothing but Brahman. Isha Vasyam Idam. The entire universe is pervaded by Ishvara. Here, Ishvara means Nirguna Brahman plus Saguna Brahman also we can take. Because according to Purusha Suktam, Ishvara is 1/4 only. Vyavaharika Ishvara, the Saguna Ishvara, is occupying 1/4. And 3/4 is Nirguna Brahman only. what is manifesting in the form of name and form in this entire universe, Brahmanda, all galaxies, planets, and all species, everything, whatever you see, whatever you can imagine, any loka, 14 lokas, all put together, only 1/4. What is that mantra? All of you know that. Padosya Vishwa Bhutani Tripadasyamritam Divi. Padosya Vishwa Bhutani. Vishwa Bhutani means this entire universe, Nama Rupa Bhutani, all species, beings, names and forms, five elements put together. Vishwa Bhutani Asya Padaha, only 1/4. Padosya Vishwa Bhutani. Then what about other 3/4 na? Tripadasyamritam Divi. Amritam Divi. Amritam means Nirgunam Brahman. Tripadam. 3/4 is Amritam Brahma. Nirgunam Brahma. Formless Brahman. That is the mantra given in Purusha Suktam. So Nirgunam Brahma alone is there. In the form of Sagunam Brahma, 1/4 he is manifesting. So whom we are worshipping, the Lord Rama, Krishna, Shiva, Devi, all are 1/4, one Ishvara in different forms manifesting. 1/4 only Vyavaharika Ishvara, Saguna Ishvara, Sakara Brahma, that Brahman. But everything is Nirgunam or Sagunam, but Brahman alone. Either it is Nirgunam, attributeless, or that which has got attributes within time, yugas and kalpas, within time and space also, that is also Brahman only, but in Saguna form. Therefore, Sadashiva Brahmendra says, Sarvam Brahmamayam. This is the Kriti we have to understand very carefully. There is a possibility of misinterpreting this Kriti. Therefore, I would like to give two ways of interpretations to this Kriti. Sarvam Brahmamayam Rere. First line is over. Then, first Charanam, Kim Vachaniyam. Kim vachaniyam, kim avachaniyam. What is there to be said? Kim vachaniyam, what is there to be said? Kim vachaniyam, kim avachaniyam, what is there not to be said? Here, kim akshepaarthe kim, natu prashnaarthe. It is not a question, but it is an answer hidden in that what is there? Kim Vachaniyam. See, from Brahman angle, Jnani angle if we see, and Ajnani angle we can see. For Jnani, who knows his higher nature, Paramarthika Satyam Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, from that standpoint, higher nature standpoint, there is no vidhi, no nishedha. Shastra gives vidhi nishedha. Vidhi means do's, nishedha means don'ts. What is to be done, what is not to be done, vidhi nishedhas are there. Ko vidhi ko nishedha, ekatva manupashyataha. So the one who sees everything is Brahman, that Jnani is beyond do's and don'ts. From him, Shastra itself withdraws. Shastra says, I am no more giving vidhi nishedha to you. My job is over. Shastra says. What it means? It means, Jnani never violate dharma. Jnani always within righteous way of life only. Because he, dharma becomes his personality or her personality. That is the status of a Jnani. So that jnani has nothing to accomplish because he already accomplished purnaha. What is there to accomplish? To accomplish something, you have to talk something, you have to write something, you have to desire something, you have to worship some god, and you have to do something. After accomplishing, nothing else remain to speak, to read, or to worship, or to enjoy, or not to enjoy. Nothing is there because everything is Brahman. So that everything is Brahman is from jnani standpoint. Now we have to see from ajnani standpoint also. Beautifully we can present this way: kim vachaniyam kim avachaniyam. Until you attain that brahma jnanam, shastra gives some vidhi and nishedha. One has to follow do's and don'ts. What is that do's and don'ts? Shastra means that which protects. How it protects? Shasanat trayate. By commanding you what is to be done, what is not to be done, rules and regulation it gives, and you follow what is to be done and you avoid what is not to be done. What are all prohibited, you avoid. By that shastra protects you. तस्मात् शास्त्रं प्रमाणन्ते कार्याकार्यौ व्यवस्थितौ. भगवान कृष्ण सेस इन भगवद्गीता. देयरफॉर फॉर अज्ञानी, फॉर एन इग्नोरेंट पर्सन, विधि निषेध आर कंपलसरी. ही हैज टू फॉलो. किम वचनीयम, व्हाट आर ऑल देयर टू स्पीक. What is there to be said means you have to see satyam vachanam, priya vachanam, hita vachanam. One has to say. Then kim avachaniyam, asatya vachanam, apriya vachanam, anrita vachanam or asatya vachanam, ahitam, one should not say. So like that we have to interpret. For ajnani, self-ignorant people, the vidhi nishedha is compulsory. Then kim rachaniyam, kim arachaniyam. What is there to be, or what is there to do? Rachaniyam means here to design, to plan, to do, to perform. What is there to do for an ajnani? The vidhi is the performance of noble karmas. Dharmic karma one has to do. Arachaniyam, unrighteous, immoral, unethical should not be done. Those actions should not be done. Arachaniyam. Kim arachaniyam, that should not be done. Kim rachaniyam, that should be done. That way we have to interpret. So both the ways we can see, for jnani and for ajnani also. So that is a very nice interpretation, I feel. Then second charanam, kim pathaniyam, kim apathaniyam. What is there to be learnt? What is there not to be learnt? What is there to be learnt? You have to learn scriptures. Shastram, Purana, Itihasa, Brahma Sutras, Dharma Shastram, Manusmriti, Apastambha Sutras. There are so many moral, ethical books are there. So many other Granthas are there to study for us. That is to be Pathaniyam. Kim Apathaniyam, which are all not congenial spiritually, they irreligious, kim apathaniyam, they should not be learnt. That's why royal path, rajamargam, chakkani rajamargam is shastra margam. Shastra or Veda is the rajamargam that one has to learn from the guru. किम भजनीयम सेकंड चरणम सेकंड हाफ किम भजनीयम किम भजनीयम किम भजनीयम व्हाट इज देयर टू बी वर्शिप्ड सात्विक देवता वन हैज टू वर्शिप एंड सात्विक पूजा सात्विक दानम सात्विकम एवरीथिंग सात्विकम वन हैज टू डू What is kim abhajaniyam? What is there not to be worshipped? One should not worship those tamasika devatas. One has to come to sattvika devatas. One has to drop or avoid worshipping all these bhuta, preta, pisacha, all those things. Bhagavan Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita 17th chapter. Rajasika devatas, tamasika devatas, tamasika people worship. So one has to go beyond that. Then, therefore, sarvam brahmamayam, everything is Brahman. Nirgunam also Brahman, sagunam also Brahman only. Nothing else is there other than Brahman. Then third charanam he gives. In Kathopanishad, Yamadharma Raja says, अन्यत्र धर्मात अन्यत्र अधर्मात कृत अकृतात सो किम बोद्धव्यम व्हाट इज देयर टू बी नोन व्हाट इज देयर नॉट टू बी नोन किम बोद्धव्यम किम अबोद्धव्यम व्हाट इज देयर टू बी नोन दैट इज टू बी नोन ऑल Righteous things, constructive, positive things you have to know. And what is not to be known about Nastikas, Nastika Matams, Nastika Vada, Nastika, all this not to be known. We need not know. So all negative things, destructive things, better not to know all of them. So therefore we have to read good books, read good magazines, read always, listen good things, noble things, see noble things and speak noble words like that. According to that Jnani, from Jnani standpoint, Annadeva Viditat Atho Aviditat Athin. Brahman is not noble, not unknowable. It comes Anyadeva Vidita. Keno Upanishad says, Brahman is beyond known and unknown. It is very difficult to understand these mantras unless we study Shastra thoroughly. We cannot grasp that much easily. What is there not to be known? We need not know about destructive or unhealthy negative things in the world, because spend your time for always noble things, good things, dharmic things. Then kim bhoktavyam kim abhoktavyam, what is there to be enjoyed? Enjoy all pleasant things which are connected to God, dharma, that is to be enjoyed. You moderate ethical, all those to be enjoyed. Legitimate and moderately you enjoy for Ajnani's sake. Jnani is beyond all those things. Never desire anything. Nothing is there for him to desire else. Second thing is not there. From Ajnani standpoint, Vidhi is what? That is to be enjoyed, which is dharmic. Connected to God and moral, ethical. Kim abhoktavyam, what is there not to be enjoyed? Illegitimate, immoderate pleasures not to be enjoyed. They have to be avoided. So these are all vidhi nishedhas for ajnanis. Jnani is beyond vidhi nishedha. It does not mean Jnani can do anything whatever he wants. First of all, Shastra says he will not do or she will not do. It is difficult for them to go against Dharma. That is what Shastra says. It is very difficult for a jnani to go to trespass the dharma, because dharma becomes his or her own personality. Helplessly they have to be dharmic. That is the status of a jnani. Now what is the final line? Sarvatra sada hamsa dhyanam kartavyam bho mukti nidhanam bho. Bhona low, in English they say low. Bhona addressing again. Bho hamsadhyanam kartavyam. Everywhere, when, where, everywhere, sarvatra, sada, all the time. Sarvatra refers to place, sada refers to time. Hamsadhyanam kartavyam means mahavakya vicharaha karaniyam ityarthaha. Mahavakya vichara means nididhyasanam, aham brahmasmi nididhyasanam, hamsadhyanam, prajnanam brahma, aham brahmasmi, ayam atma brahma, tattvamasi. Guru says tattvamasi. We have to say aham brahmasmi, kartavyam bho. Why? Why I have to do this nididhyasanam? Because it is mukti nidhanam, which is assures liberation. This hamsa dhyanam, mahavakya vichara, assures liberation. That is why one has to do that hamsa dhyanam nididhyasanam. Now with this, this kriti is over, and then finally, as Yamadharmaraja tells in Kathopanishad, Uttishthata Jagrata Prapya Varani Bodhata. Arise and awake and approach a guru, study Shastra, attain moksha. Acharyat Kadhita Vidya Sadhishtam Prapatana. Acharya, guru is very important. We have to take guru and surrender to guru and listen to guru's words, Shastra, and along with Achara. Achara heenam na punanti vedaha. Without Achara, without disciplines, Shastra cannot purify him, refine the person. Achara heenam na punanti vedaha. Vedas cannot help such a person who is not following any vidhi nishedha. So follow vidhi nishedha, then come to beyond vidhi nishedha status, that is jnani status. So these are the words of Sadashiva Brahmendra Saraswati. So first start with saguna dhyana, upasana. Meditation is meditation is a preparation for contemplation. Contemplation is the culmination of meditation. Meditation is Saguna Ishvara, objective meditation. Saguna Ishvara Dhyana. Contemplation is Nirguna Brahma Dhyanam, that is Jnana Sahita Dhyanam. That is called contemplation. So we have to understand the purport of Sadashiva Brahmendra Kritis, and beautifully he introduced Saguna Ishvara as a sadhana, upasana, and finally culminates into Vedanta. It takes you to that Guru, Shastra, and Jnana Prapti, Moksha Prapti. With this, I conclude Sadashiva Brahmendra Kritis. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harih Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harih Om.